गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू SRBPS वर्चुअल क्लासरूम। आई एम अर्चना झा, योर टीचर टू टीच यू इंग्लिश। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट लैंग्वेज। लैंग्वेज इज द रोड मैप ऑफ अ कल्चर। इट टेल्स यू वेयर इट्स पीपल कम फ्रॉम एंड वेयर दे आर गोइंग। वी ऑल यूज वन और द अदर लैंग्वेज टू एक्सप्रेस आवर फीलिंग्स। यस, द मोस्ट familiar one for us is our mother tongue. We do practice it from very early childhood and we learn other languages later on. Learning any other language is not only learning different words for the same thing, but learning another way to think about things. So, most of us are more comfortable in speaking or using our mother tongue. And that is obvious because we practice it a lot. But learning any language with development of certain skills that help us to have better command on that language. Let's learn about them. Students, we need to know about the grammar of that particular language. When we are learning about that grammar, it helps us to learn that language in a correct form. But more than that, we do require certain language skills. What are those? First, listening skill. Second, speaking skill. Third, reading skill. And then writing skill. Recall how you learnt your mother tongue. You must have heard few words from your parents or close ones. You try to speak those words. And later on, when you started learning that language, you started reading and writing. And that's why you are so comfortable in that language. But did you follow the same for the learning of your second language? Most of the time, no. If you will follow the same, then you will definitely be comfortable in any of the language, right? So start listening, then speaking, then come for reading, and then go for writing. That will help you to be comfortable in any language. I compare learning language with that of building making. So how it is there? Let's see. As sand forms the smallest particle of any building material, so are our alphabet. Now joining those sands gets molded into brick, and same way if we join one or two letters we get words. When we are arranging these bricks in a particular pattern we get wall. Same way the arrangement of words makes sentences and helps to create language. Later on we do decorate our wall with some paintings. Those beautiful paintings make our wall beautiful, and so happens with our language also when we introduce figure of speech in that. All these parts will be taken separately in separate classes. Today I am going to talk about the smallest particle of any language. Now here we are going to learn about English language. Yes. Every language has an alphabet, means a set of letters. In English, we have A to Z, 26 letters. They are divided in two, that is vowel and consonant. Let me tell you that these letters represent sounds, and it is sound that matters in language. So vowel means these letters are representing certain sounds which are known as vowel sounds, like a, a, e, o, u. Remember, sounds, same is with consonants also. Now joining these sounds or letters we form words. So how can we define words? A sound or group of sounds that expresses a meaning and forms an independent unit of a language. So that is the alphabet or letters can be taken as smallest unit, and this is another unit of language. Now all types of words can be categorized as parts of speech Parts of speech are 8 in number. Parts of speech refers to 8 categories into which English words are divided. Name of all these divisions are Latin terms. Now here I am just going to highlight what is this Latin terms. Now listen students, English has its origin from Latin or Greek words. So vocabulary of English is basically based on these two. Though it is called inclusive language as it welcomes many other words from different languages. As we are having the base language Sanskrit for our mother tongue Hindi, same way English has these two main origin. What are those? Greek and Latin. So here we are going to learn about parts of speech which basically are Latin terms, right? Now, all these 8 categories can be named like this. Number 1, noun. It is from Latin word nomen, meaning name. Examples are given here. Boy, school, ram, class and copper. And detail about it we will do when we will learn noun with its types. Next is the introduction of second parts of speech, that is pronoun, which is again combination of Latin word only. Pro means for, and we know that pronoun is used for noun or in place of noun. So examples: he, she, this and that. Next is adjective. Again, it means in Latin, thrown to a noun, and we know that adjective describes about noun. Example, tall, more, many, etc. Next is verb. Verb again is from Latin word verbum, and it is known as action word also. We have example here, play, being and having. Next, adverb. Adverb is the word which modifies verb, right? So it's some examples are given here: nicely, there, today, twice, etc. Next is preposition. A preposition is a word which is placed before a noun and it relates that noun with the rest of the sentence. Examples are given here: between, behind, etc. Now next example is, next part of speech is conjunction. Conjunction again is combination of two words. Con represents together, junct represents join. So these are joining words, and examples: nevertheless, however, since, etc. Next, 8th one is interjection. It is again to express surprise or anger. Example is given here like bravo, oh, etc. Now this way we have introduced all 8 parts of speech. Let's have a recap. We learned today about parts of speech. They are 8 in number. Number 1, noun, pronoun, then adjective, verb, adverb, then preposition, conjunction and interjection. So this way we have got the introduction of parts of speech, as we have revised about the different units of our language. Individually, all these topics will be discussed in different coming classes. And your homework for today is already given in your Dropbox. So I'm just wait for the next class. We will do it in detail. Till then, do that homework and stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.